to these remote locations and they inform them about like taking proper care of themselves and help them through diseases.
Through international support, they reach areas where most natural disasters are happening, and they find any possible way they can to help them. Like in recent times of COVID, they were able to raise money and donate lots of masks and care for frontline helpers, like doctors and nurses.
So one thing I want to add here, especially I want to call out is, in addition to what they have explained, I myself got a chance to visit the Balashram and the healthcare center. I was totally amazed, and I was like kind of felt tears when I visit the Balashram and the medical facility. So basically the Balashram, when I look at the kids, they're so innocent, and the kind of education that they get it, I feel like they are better off compared to our kids getting like a, they get all they follow the CBSE syllabus, and in addition to that one, their morning work starts morning 5 o'clock with yoga, exercise and meditation. That's a mandatory, okay? And also, in addition to that, they will also do the regular studies like other kids. And till now, since we are doing for the last 11 years, the whole batch, the complete batch which started from the kindergarten, they already completed that. And some of them even settled in the jobs. And I got the recent statistics. Like and an average of 400-500 kids they take from first grade to the 12th grade. Okay, so an average of that many kids they took it. So they have something after the kids that who completed their schooling. They also started something like kind of vocational courses where kids can excel there. So that one thing they have recently started. And I also got a chance to visit and meet some of the doctors there in the healthcare center. It's a big facility. It's all like if I observe that when we started this, there was nothing actually. So now there's a big facility there. You can see the picture about the Balashram and in the medical center. It's like a 3-story building. But one thing is, everything is free there. Okay, unless like people who doesn't want to have any problems, they just not just only sick patients who have their like a regular chronic diseases also will be treated. So in addition to that one, they also have the dental treatment also they provide, and some of the visiting doctors also they come and do the treatments there. Okay, so that's one thing. One thing, the big takeaway from me is just not only the India. So one thing I liked about the organization is they are wherever the need is there in the world, they come forward. Okay, like for example, the recent Hurricane Harvey in Houston, all of you know like how much we got impacted. And a couple of years before, Oklahoma tornado, I think you know all about this. And even even countries like Pakistan also, where the floods came a couple of years before, they came forward and helped. So especially for the Hurricane Harvey, I got a chance to work with them very closely, and they donated a lot of money during that time, who were the people in need. Okay, and even Mexico, Haiti, earthquake, all those things, they came forward and wherever the need is there, they are there to help the people. Okay, so that's, and recent COVID also, like as the kids explained, they was amazed. Like some, you know, all of you know, in the beginning it was very tough to gather all the masks and everything. We were struggling, scared to go outside, but they made it. During that time, getting the mask is like a luxury. Okay, so during that time also, they came forward and came up with the surgical mask and provided all of these to the frontline employees. So it's amazing work the people are doing. So it's not just only here in Dallas. The Dallas is, we are so lucky that I'm very happy that so many vibrant and dynamic volunteers are here. And I want to explicitly call out one of my main volunteer, Shekhar Brahmadevara. Shekhar, you want to say? He's one of my, he's been, we have been doing, but I was alone when we started. Like when I started, like in the 10 years before, I was literally going, and because it was very tough for me to go and convince everybody. But now I don't know, I just started my work like 2 weeks before, and everybody else, the volunteers do it. So that's what, like the beginning, it was tough, but now after Shekhar joined, it is more cleaner and faster for me. It's just not only that we are doing, now we started doing even the table tennis also. We are now running like twice or thrice a year. Okay, so there is a separate table tennis tournament that goes, the funds that are raised also will go to hand in hand USA. So these are the different activities. If anybody wants to be a volunteer and you feel proud of the work that you are doing, I definitely feel proud. Shekhar 100% feel proud of the work that you are doing. But if you want to be proud of doing this work, please reach out to me or Shekhar. We have a lot of work is there, and we can share this, and we can add more value to the community. Okay. Having said that, we are about to start the walkathon now, and after the walkathon, since you get tired and you will have energy, you will get filled, and you have a breakfast is also there. So please not miss. Okay.